Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I'm glad you're here. We are going to talk about what a hot dog vendor needs on day one. Okay. And this question comes from, let me pull this up real quick. This comes from Avid Hiker. Apparently I missed this question by one day and I got slammed for it. And then I got double slammed. I'll read that to you in just a minute. So, here's the question. Avid Hiker asks, can you do a short video giving your exact recommendations on what to stock the average cart with? Now, this is, could be a problem because what to stock an average cart with would be a longer video than a shorter one. And then recommended brands, recommended where to buy these brands, and give us approximates on what we should expect to pay for each item. That would be really helpful. I can do all of that except for one, and that's short video, Avid. That isn't going to happen. Not if you want all those answered and you want real answers. I mean, I could answer it like somebody would that's never done this and go, okay, you're going to need hot dogs, buns, ketchup, and you'll need a cart. And then the best brand is Boar's Head, and you can buy that through Sysco. And you can expect to pay roughly $59 for a case, a 10-pound case of 4-to-1s, and that would be it. But that wouldn't give you anything to work off of, and it wouldn't be honest. I mean, it would be honest, but it's narrowed down so far that it wouldn't apply to everybody, and that could be a problem. So I'm going to help you with a lot of this. I'd ask you a question. This is the same day. So this was yesterday. I'd ask you a question, but you don't answer 99% of your viewer questions. 99%. I go through the list and it shows I do, but I don't know where these other questions are. Somehow, though, I did miss yours. I will admit to that. I missed it and I apologized for it. I don't know how I missed it. Who is it jumped in here? Pizza Pizza. Oh, y'all remember Pizza Pizza. Totally agree, he says. And they both go on this rant about trying to get an answer to a simple question. If I'd go back and watch his long videos, he has no clue how to utilize social media. You're probably right there. I don't know that I'm trying to utilize it other than just to spread information. You may mean utilize it for profit. I haven't nailed that one down real well yet. But if you notice, I don't run ads on my thing. I used to. I quit. And just because it's annoying. I hate getting them, so I figured my customers probably did too. So I quit running ads, you know. And I'm still a YouTube partner, but I just don't run ads. I just opt out on every video. So, I've already spent a lot of your time and I haven't even started yet. Anyway, people hate long-winded 20-minute videos that could be done more effectively in a to-the-point video. I guess this is why I have so few, he has so few subscribers after 5+ years. That could be it. I have no idea. But the bottom line is, Avid, I want to apologize for missing your question the other day. I don't know how I missed it. It didn't even appear. Usually it puts up the new ones on my dashboard up top. Yours never came up top. It just stayed down for whatever reason. But I did search your name through the dashboard and found it. Cause I found your complaint. Then I found your other thing. So anyway, there's that. So let's get started. Let's find out what the hot dog vendor needs. Okay. On his first day, I'm going to give you a list, a checklist, the whole works. Okay. And I've already provided links in the bottom. I want to make sure everything's working okay here. Glad you're here. Broccoli Heart checking in from Los Angeles, Dragon Wieners and Catering here. Mike's here. Thanks for being here. And Australia. Love it. Love it, brother. Is it Mike or Mick? Mick? Hopefully I did it right. Anyway, so Here's the deal. There's so many variables. See, this is where it gets long-winded. And I think the problem is, if you look at my first videos, I didn't know as much. I had my experience. I hadn't had thousands of vendors' experience. So I just had my experience. And so I applied that and I taught that. But then as the years went by, I learned from other vendors. I vended more. I ran into other problems in other states when I'd go to do this event or go help a vendor or go train some a group of vendors. Whatever I did, I'd run into new stuff. And so you get this bucket of knowledge. And then when somebody asks you a question that you would think, it's kind of like, how do you build a house? Can you give me a real to the point, real quick answer on how to build a house? No. I can't. I don't know how to do that. How would anybody do that? So here we go. Let me pull this up real quick. I'm going to see if I can, I'm going to give you a free cost analysis, but I'm also going to give you a checklist, but I want to run through some of this with you so that you know what these things are real quickly. Okay. It's a cart checklist that was made by two friends of mine who are vendors. They like cohorted together and created this cool kick butt list, and you can change it. So it's a list that you can change to fit your needs, but you can check off stuff for your prep. And it covers the stuff that you would need, you know, your vehicle fluids, your tire pressures, the normal stuff. Then you have cart stuff. Some vendors are in areas where they need wheel blocks, fire extinguisher, chairs, folding tables, boiling pans, steam pans. And the thing is you'll want to go through this checklist every time, because you may get to a friend of mine, John Cavanaugh, goes to an event and forgot his freaking hot dogs. He forgot them. Cases of them forgot them. Because your mind gets wrapped up and it's easy to forget something. So this is a long list, Avid, and I hope you'll forgive me if I don't read it all. But there's a ton of stuff. Some of it will not apply to you. Some of it will not apply to you. But for the most part, it will apply to 99% of you. You'll go, okay, I do need my hot sauce. I do need my first aid kit. I do need my condiment squeeze bottles. I need pens. I need a cooler. I need my aprons, my foil wrap, my napkin, Ziploc. You got it? So I have all this stuff listed out for you on a file that I'll give you here in a little bit. Okay? And it'll be in the video description thing or, you know, whatever. After this is over, I think it shows up. Now, here's the next question you had asked, Avid, and it was a good question, is how do you source this stuff? Okay. Let me find that and make sure that I'm right. Okay. So recommending brands is tricky, because I've talked about this numerous times, and I know you said, I can't watch 1,000 videos to find one answer. And I agree with you. That would be a freaking nightmare. Okay. So here's the deal though. If you're looking for a hot dog brand, I would go to the grocery store, and I'm going to give you just one example. I'd go to the grocery store and I would look at what's selling the most of. How do I know what they're selling the most of? What are they stocking and displaying the most of? That's how you can tell. That's popular for that store, for that area around that store, their customers. You may go to the other side of town and they may have more Boar's Head than Ballpark. So that gives you a starting point. But I always teach, and I teach in my book, my course book, that if you will go and do a taste test, so pick some brands that are the most popular or you think they are in your area, and use those. I've talked about not picking some off the wall brand because, man, I'm from Chicago and Vienna's the number one brand. It is, and it's delicious. But try to teach people in East Tennessee what a Vienna hot dog is, and they'll go, oh, I don't want that mushy thing out of a can, because they think Vienna sausages. And I did that. I made that exact mistake. So here's what I want you to remember. Stick with the brands that are local to your area. Then don't try to educate your customer yet. You don't want to educate them on a new brand. Or find a popular brand you like, a Ballpark or whatever, and call it your own. Put some seasoning in the water and now it's your brand, okay? It's like Hot Dog Mike. He got a world record. We went out and filmed him. He's cool as hell. Hot Dog Mike, he did he never told us what brand he was using. It's a Hot Dog Mike brand. What brand is your hot dog? Hot Dog Mike's. See, he branded himself instead of branding Nathan's or Vienna or Sabrette or any of those. So now what do I like? I like Boar's Head. I love Boar's Head hot dogs. But Nathan's are fantastic. Sabrette, fantastic. Vienna, fantastic. There's a lot of them that are fantastic. There's some of them that suck, but they suck because I'm not used to them, their texture or their flavor or whatever. Okay? They may be popular somewhere else. So you want to do it to your geographic area. Now, this goes with all your products, but you don't want to have to taste test all your products, but you kind of know. You don't go get Dollar General brand ketchup and leave that on your cart. Okay? If you do, put it in your own squirt bottle. A lot of vendors do that. Some vendors add a little bit of sugar to it. Some vendors add a little barbecue to it or cumin to their freaking mayonnaise or to their ketchup. You can do some cool things and make it your own, but you want to be consistent with that. Now, I'm going to give you another link to a cost analysis thing that will help you break down cost analysis. But as far as picking and choosing, I would do a taste test. Pick those popular brands that you think are good, three or four or five of them. Have a home cooking. Don't even have to have the cart. You can do it from your kitchen. Have friends and family over. Slice up and ask them to please refrain from use as minimal condiments as possible on their taste test ones. Put color-coded toothpicks in the same brand. So if I got Boar's Head and Ballpark, let's say just for example, I'll put blue toothpicks and all the bite-sized pieces of Boar's Head and red toothpicks in the Oscar Mayer or the Ballpark or whatever. And I would do it that way. That's how I would separate and find out, oh, which one did you like better? I like the Ballpark, man. That was, or the blue toothpick. They won't know what it is. See? And you can do a blind taste test that way. You can go double blind and have somebody else mix it up so you don't even know. That's a cool one. So that's the best way to do your taste test on your dogs, which is a crucial part of your meal. Now, picking out products such as drinks and stuff, I go into this multiple times on multiple videos. It's in the basic. In fact, what I just told you is in the basic free training videos. You'll spend less than an hour. I think it's 8 videos long. And it goes through from start to finish, to getting a license, commissary, to picking products, to taste testing, all the way down, less than an hour of videos. So that's in the free training at the top of either of our pages, learnhotdogs.com or benscarts.com. It's at the top. It says free training. So you can watch that little series and that will help give you a foothold. But now you've got other products, right? You've got other products to think about and learn about. Now, where do you buy all these products? Well, if you're starting on a shoestring budget like I did, I started these products from my grocery store. Not the cheapest way to go, but it worked for me and it was what I could afford. I couldn't afford a case of hot dogs. Even though a case was $20, I couldn't afford the membership at Sam's at the time so that I could buy the case of hot dogs for $20. And that's for 80 hot dogs. So that's what you have to look at. Now, If not that money's no object, but if money is not like you have enough to get going, go ahead and get you either one of these big box retailers like Sam's or BJ's or Costco, get one of their memberships if you want, or just do this. This came from a friend of mine, Jason Brown, owns Love Food Truck Company. And what he did is he taught us about broadline distributors, broadline, two words, broadline distributors. And you can Google that. You can Google broadline distributor near me and it will pull up. Google will just know, Abbott Hiker lives here and here's his broadline distributors. Call them up because they typically don't have minimums. They'll let you try it before you buy it kind of deal. They'll even do a taste test with you. Okay, without you spending money, and you kind of get an idea. They'll let you sample stuff, take it home and sample it with your customers. And if they don't have a brand that you want, I've got to have Vienna's Neon Green Relish. They'll order it in for you in bulk. You get the wholesale cost, but you don't have to buy it in bulk. So something that Sam's or Costco wouldn't do for you, a broadline distributor will. So that's the best information I can give you on that. Now, the next thing is let's see, I want to make sure I covered this. Approximate what we can expect to pay for each item. I have a cost sheet breakdown. I am going to find it after I get done with this video, and I will attach it, a link to it, so that you can download it, print it, read it, whatever you want to do. It will be a cost breakdown of everything that I typically buy for the cart, okay? And it will be an updated version. It's on learnhotdogs.com. I just don't know where, so I'm going to find it for you. I should have had that done ahead of time, but I didn't, so I apologize. But so what you're going to get is you're going to get that. I already have the links. I did manage to pull the links, the other two links that you had asked about, plus how to pick out, sourcing, pricing, how to do a cost analysis, and how to choose which dogs to choose, which products to choose, how to taste test, all that stuff. And then a list of what you'll need for your cart on day one and every day following. And then, I'm also going to give you another one. If for new vendors, this is a good one. And it's the top 40 questions I get asked almost daily. I don't get all 40 every day, but I get all 40 every week guaranteed. And some of them multiple times. So I created a list called, the top 40 list. And if you go to learnhotdogs.com/40, it'll pull it up for you. I've also put it in the links below. They should be there. If they're not, when this publishes, it will be. I don't know if it does it when it's live. I can't see it. So that will give you the top 40 questions asked with the answers. I answer them short, and then I broke them into five answers each for each video, five questions for each video, so that you don't have to watch miles of video. So that has been up there on the site. I updated it, but the bottom line, it's been up there for years, but I've updated the videos as the top 40 questions changed for obvious reasons. Let's see. I think that's it. I want to check one other thing. If you can bear with me just a second, I got to pull this up. Don't know where it is, but I'm going to find it. Okay. Let me see if I can get this up. This will help me tell you what I've got coming for. Well, that didn't work. Okay. That didn't work. Okay. Either way, here's the deal. I'm going to have you. I've got a bunch of questions that got submitted today that I'm not going to be able to do today, and I'll do tomorrow. And they're good questions, and I'm going to run through them. So if you're one of those people that were expecting the answer today, I apologize. There's just not enough time, and I'm going to get in trouble if I go. I'm already almost 20 minutes because I just talk. I apologize. Let's see. What about Nathan's? Nathan's dogs, another good one. But see, you want to taste test. You want to taste test because some people don't know what that is, and it doesn't mean a hill of beans to them. You could put it on your cart, but they go, okay, he's got Nathan's. You could have put, he's got Bob's, because they wouldn't know. I felt that way the first time I went to an event, and the vendor, about four people from me, he's advertising Sabrette hot dogs, the original Sabrette dog. And I was going, what the hell? What's a Sabrette? I don't want one. You know that, I mean, it was kind of, and I outdid him. I could tell by the line. Like, we didn't pull out our wallets at the end of the day and count, but I could tell by, I always had a line, he didn't. And I could tell because I think he was advertising something nobody knew in East Tennessee. Sabrette? Nobody knew what that was. And so, and I made the same mistake when I brought in Vienna. It was a short-lived mistake. I want to make sure I get everybody's questions on here. Do you offer any classes like Mark does at the Vienna place in Chicago? No, but I do better than that, Avid Hiker. Great question. I do better than that. I have rigged up a deal, okay, a backdoor type deal with some pro vendors in our Vendors United group to give you free training on a real cart live at their locations, from a food trailer to a food truck to a hot dog cart. It's all your bases are covered. So Avid, if you want to do that, it's absolutely free. And I'll go a step further. And I'm going to give you the link if you want to check this out, and anybody else can check this out. This is 100% free to you. You do have to get there, right? So I'm going to give you, this is the catch. I'm going to give you $300 if you go and you later buy a cart from me. Okay, I think it's in the first 90 days after you go to training. I'm going to give you a $300 credit towards your training, your expense to go. Okay, because I know it costs something to go unless you happen to be in the same town or a few towns over. But bottom line is they are backed up because they already have people coming. The web address for that, let me type this in here so everybody has it. It's learnhotdogs.com/bestdayever. Okay, if you go to that link, you can go train with one of these pro vendors. Okay, I have a food truck, a food trailer, and a cart. You can go train with them. You can go train with like Mark Lawler on a Cater Pro. You can go train with Billy Cassavant with Boss Dogs in a Stand King. You can go train with the Jason Brown, okay, in a food truck and get more information than you would get in 5 years of vending on your own. So that's the kind of thing you can get. Now, if you don't like that and you want something where you just walk, we took Michael Wood, who's been using a big dog cart for 9 years, roughly. Okay. And he just bought a brand new one just 2 weeks ago. And he's been using the same big dog for all that time. He is in a podunk town in Georgia. He kicks butt. He let us film basically for a couple days to get a day's worth of information. And it's like a mini course. It's a day in the life of a vendor. So if you can't afford or can't schedule it into your schedule, maybe you can't afford it to travel, but you can't get it in your schedule because you work or whatever. You can watch this video series. I think it's less than 10 bucks, I believe. Okay. We had it originally for $300 and I've got it right now for like 10 bucks. It's the busy season and I just dumped it out there. I called Michael and said, do you care? He said, no, I think it's great. And you get to follow him from setup to prep to cleanup to serving to how different ways to do it, everything right over his shoulder and hear it, see it and all. Great question though. Okay. You've won me over and I appreciate you and your thoroughness more now. Evan, I appreciate it, brother. I do. Let's see. It's worth every minute you'll spend watching them. Thank you, Dragon Wieners. Hey, Ben, on the go. Hot Dogs Catering's here. Should start slinging the first week of May. Got my big dog card on Monday and so pumped to get going. Thanks for everything. Preacher Man, love you, brother, and happy for you. I can't wait to get pictures. I can't wait to see, you know, your progress. That'll be fun. I got some today that were cool. And every time I get something like that, I kid you not. I don't know if you can see this, but chill bumps. I get freaking chill bumps because it excites me. And I know that sounds crazy. And it's probably because I am. I'm a little crazy. Music City in the house. Glad you're here. Anyway, thank you, Mick from Australia. I think it's freaking awesome you're from Australia and you're here. Anyway, love you, and I hope you kick butt. If you have any other questions, post them up. I'll try not to miss them. If you don't get answered quickly, you know, pretty quickly, post it again or email me. Go ben@learnhotdogs.com. Email me. It won't put you on some list, okay? You have to actually sign up for a list if you want a list. And just so you know, for all of those who watch the lemonade vending stuff, I put out a brand new article. Nobody knows about it yet because I posted it about 10 minutes before. I spent hours on this thing. 10 minutes before this started, I posted it up on the blog at learnhotdogs.com. It is bad to the bone. It gives you every link to every source, whether you're going big or you're going small. It gives you the pros and cons. It gives you all the stuff you need, the supplies, how to get licensed. It gives you everything. It's all there. Learnhotdogs.com. It'll be the first one because I just posted it. So get paid like RJ, highly interested in lemonade stand and hot dog stand as well. You don't even need a lemonade stand. I talk about a pop-up table. Okay. I've been following you for a year now. I built my cart because of you. You are crazy as a pet coon, but I love you, dude. I love you, bro. I love it. And you'll be launching 4/13. That's freaking 9 days from now, brother. That's freaking awesome. Wish I could get a hot dog cart started here, but rules suck big time. Nick, we have vendors there. We have vendors in Australia. Some of them had a tough road to hoe to get started, but you can get it done. Okay. But yeah, I'm with you. I know some of y'all's codes, but it's doable. There's vendors over there. Pumped out and ready to go. Thanks for all the information. Phyllis, thank you. Very nice. Michael, thank you for the compliment. Peter, again, thank you. I appreciate it a bunch. And Dragon Wieners just said, everything is on track for the 16th grand opening here. And Kokomo. That reminds me of that song from the 80s, Kokomo. Way down in Kokomo. I don't know. It was a pop song. I'm not going to try to butcher that up for you. And Cheryl Hager's in the house. Thank y'all a bunch. I love you. I'll talk to you later.